Hey everyone, my name is Sarah, Sarah Jane actually, and just want to start off by saying please excuse the background. This is my office. It's also a catch-all. It has not been renovated yet, as you can see right here. This is actually the color we're going to paint the room. It hasn't been painted yet. We just moved in here late fall of last year. And this one and then the master bed and bath are the last ones that needed to be finished being renovated. So excuse all of this. And this is actually the closet right there. The closet right there. It's actually my grow closet. So I'm a gardener. So that's where I had all my vegetables. And there's actually lights set up in there. And then plus there's like totes of my crafts. So let me just explain the background first. Now that's all over because I know you're going to wonder. Introduce myself. Like I said, my name is Sarah. Most people who know me close enough or grew up with me, they do call me Sarah Jane. And I'm from Tennessee. I'm 30 years old. And I am going to have the RNY, RNY gastric bypass. I'm actually pre-op right now. And my insurance requires that I do 6 months of medically monitored diet prior to getting the surgery, you know, and plus, of course, you know, like the psyche valve, you know, and clearances and all that jazz. So, you know, I obviously have to do all of that as well. But on top of that, I do have to do the 6 months. And so, like I said, I'm in month three of that, so I'm about halfway done. So I'm guesstimating, surgery date sometime in the fall, September, October, somewhere in there. Also, just want to say, excuse my little hair tendril. we just got back from the gym, me and my husband. Who also is doing YouTube videos for his weight loss journey. If you want to follow him, his YouTube name is FireCommander92. So just out for the, you know, y'all out there who are just guys who just want to follow another guy or, you know, someone who just wants to follow a guy, you know, somebody doing just weight loss. You know, he'll explain his whole story on there. But as for me, we just got back. Well, as for us, I guess. We just got back from WLSFA this past weekend in Nashville. It was amazing. And I was really, you know, like inspired to, videos for accountability, maybe, but not for myself. Like, I don't want to do videos for just myself. Like, I don't want, you know, because I probably, well, I don't know, I might go back and watch them, but I'm the type of person, I need someone to keep me accountable because I'm an avoider. Like, I will just not worry about it. Like, I just, you know, I won't step on the scale or I won't really just even, you know, recognize what's happening, you know? And I guess that's kind of how I got to the weight that I am. By not, you know, accepting it, not recognizing it, not really, like, bringing it to light. So I really need this for other people to keep me accountable. So, you know, like, if I should not post at a time that, you know, like usually I do, or if it's been a little while since I have posted a video, then I need someone to say, hey, where are you at? You know, are you still doing good? And then, you know, I hope that will, because I'm the type of person that I do like a bit of a competitive nature, a bit of a kind of, I don't want to say show off, but like, yeah, I mean, I kind of want to be like, hey, this is what I did, you know, so that kind of spirit will keep me accountable, because I can't be like, oh, well, you know, for myself, because, you know, you can't compete with yourself, like, and obviously I can't compete with my husband, because he's a guy, and, you know, he's gonna, like, lose weight in, like, 2 months, you know, so it's not gonna be any good, yeah, so that's really what, you know, what I'm hoping for here. And just to go into, like, some background about me and us as a couple and everything, well, I've been overweight my entire life. I don't ever know a time that I wasn't, you know, larger than anyone else, height wise and, you know, weight wise. You know, I've always been a tall girl, you know, like now I'm 5'10", and I've always been, you know, on the larger, fluffier side, you know, stocky side. So, you know, with a lifetime of that, and then plus, you know, my whole family is pretty much overweight or obese. So, I mean, it's all I've known. And so I just grew up that way, and I've had things, you know, in my life that have happened. I don't necessarily blame those things. I've come to terms with them, and I've accepted that they've happened. I've forgiven, you know, the people and everything, and kind of moved on. Like, that doesn't hinder me right now. But I mean, it's there. I just, you know, over the years, I've just gotten bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Like, I wore a size 18, women's 18 pants in the 8th grade. I mean, I just did, you know? So, I've always been big. And, you know, I was actually, I might have been bigger than that to think about it. Because when I started high school, I wore a 24 women's pant. Yeah. So, I may have been like in an 18 when I was like in the 6th grade. Yeah. I don't know. But I do know that, like, I did, in high school, at my high school here, where we live in Tennessee, it may be for the whole state, Tennessee, I don't know, I don't care about any other high school, but my high school, you had to take a wellness class your freshman year, and the wellness class, half of it was, like, PE, and the other half was, like, health class. It may be all, of course, Tennessee, like I said, I don't know. They might be all over the country. Hell, I don't know. So I do know that when I had started doing that wellness class, because I had never, like, actually worked out before, ever. I mean, you have PE, but, like, when they started taking it out of schools, you know, so you had it, like, once a week. That's not going to do anything. So when I started doing this three, you know, times a week, then, you know, I really started dropping weight. And I went down to a size 20 in women's pants. And, you know, that was the first time I'd ever really, like, lost some weight. And, you know, I felt really good. And I was like, yay, I'm in these 20 pants. And, I mean, I was still fat, but it felt good to me. Like, that, hey, I can lose weight. After that semester of that wellness class was over, though, I was like, meh. No more. I didn't take another wellness class after that. I go through the rest of high school and, you know, gradually just continue to pick up weight, you know, and I kind of stayed around a 24. I don't think I ever went to a 26, but I was a 24 pretty much all through high school. Actually, I might have been closer to a 26 my senior year of high school. Was probably the biggest weight I have been besides right now. When I was my senior year in high school, I worked at a sandwich shop. And, you know, so I was there. I was eating that food all the time. It didn't work out. And, you know, I didn't know how to have a healthy lifestyle. Like, I didn't know any better. And so I just really ballooned and gained weight, and it was just, you know, whatevs. So then, after high school, I went off to college, and I went to UT Knoxville. And if anybody has ever been to Knoxville, or, you know, even that, the Appalachians, you know that it's very hilly, even mountainous, and on the campus, it is actually very, it is very, you know, hilly and everything. So that's the first time that I ever had done, like, extensive, you know, just walking. I was walking up and down hills to class, back to class, to my dorm, you know, to the cafeteria, to the UA, you know, UC, not UA, it's your analysis, to the UC. And so, you know, like, I walked everywhere. I didn't have a car. I walked everywhere. I walked up the strip. I walked back from the strip. Like, you had to walk everywhere. And also, what had happened was that I started having gallbladder issues, actually. I had gallstones. And so I started having gallbladder attacks. And I don't know, I mean, if you've ever experienced that, it's, like, horrific. And so, you know, it started off very slowly. About, I'd say, December of 2004, when I was in college. And so it progressed, you know, but eventually it ended up where, like, I couldn't keep a lot of food down and I was throwing up. But, so the walking all around campus combined with the gallbladder attacks, I know record because my doctor's scale when I was a senior in high school would not go over 350, so it was 350 plus. And then when I came back home after that first year, I was 260. So I had lost, you know, 100 pounds just doing that. And everybody was like, oh, you look so good, and blah, blah, blah. And so, you know, that was the first time I've ever had really lost a significant amount of weight. Did I know I had lost that weight? No. I still thought I was fatty, fat, fat, who wore 24 pants. Like, I honestly, even when I went shopping for clothes and I could get into, like, back into the 20s and the 18s, I had no clue. Like, I had no clue. I still thought I was really fat. But apparently I wasn't. had I known that, a different story. So, you know, progressing on from that, You know, I had gallbladder surgery. It was the result of the gallbladder attacks. I had my gallbladder taken out, and you know, I think I gained some weight after that, and I stayed at about 270-ish, 275, I guess, and 4 or 5 10 woman. I mean, that's not really, I mean, it's still obese, but it's not bad. And, and so life had happened, and, you know, there was a baby, there was a marriage, blah. And, I gained, after having my daughter, I gained up to 315, 320, something like that. And then my marriage went downhill, and I, was a single mom, and I still was in college and put myself through nursing school, while working and raising a baby. And, I had started to learn how to live healthier, like how to, you know, what, now it wasn't how I know now. I still made mistakes. Like, I still thought, you know, certain foods were good, certain, you know, and the whole low fat kick and, you know, blardy blar. But I maintained 325 for 3 years, 3-4 years. I maintained that weight. And, you know, and I worked out, and I would work out an hour and a half, probably 3 to 4 times a week. And, you know, and life was good. Then I met my husband. Well, not, scratch that, I knew him. We had known each other for, like, ever. But we met. You know what I mean? We came together as a couple and decided to start dating. And, so, there was, you know, another baby who didn't make it. And I gained 30 pounds with that. We got married, gained another 30 pounds, and this is all in the span of probably a year. I gained 60 to 100 pounds in a year. Had no clue why. After that first miscarriage, there came a second miscarriage, and another miscarriage. We had a lot of miscarriages, and it really sad. I got really depressed, and I kind of was like, I'm fat, I'm always gonna be fat, so whatevs, you know? Apparently I can't ever have children, so fine. Even though, you know, we went to a fertility doctor, and, you know, we tried to get help, fertility meds and stuff like that, it still didn't work. It still didn't help. We weren't getting pregnant, and when we were miscarrying. So, you know what, I just want to take a break. I don't even want to do this anymore. Brings us to this past year. I've had, like, you know, all the Shazam done with my fertility doctor, and I had an HSG done, HSG, yeah, and there was a polyp in my uterus. He thinks maybe that's one cause, who knows, there's a lot. I also have PCOS, which was what was causing the rapid weight gain, the past year. This was, we're three, four years ago, that was causing the rapid weight gain. And, you know, not being able to shed it no matter what I did. I would diet, I would exercise. Like, even before our wedding, you know, I tried to lose weight so I could fit in a good wedding dress. And my best friend, who was my maid of honor, she lost weight. She lost 70 pounds. Me, like 10. So, yeah. No. Whatevs on that. So present today, this past year, earlier this year, you know, I met with my fertility doctor again to see what we could do about this polyp and, you know, getting it out of my uterus and, you know, seeing what's the deal. He said he would not operate on it because I was too fat. And I was like, wonderful. Thanks for telling me, because I had no clue. and so he was like, he wasn't mean about it or anything like that. He was just like, you know, I don't want to take that risk with you. Because I'm not, you know, I'm an OBGYN RE fertility doctor. I don't, you know, if your heart should stop or whatever, like, and I'm like, I understand. High risk. You're removing a polyp from my uterus. You don't want me to die. Got it. And so he was like, you know, but have you ever thought of, you know, weight loss surgery? And I was like, yeah, I had thought about it. And actually I had, because the last, not this previous January, but the January prior. Is that right? Hell, I don't know. Anyway, one of the Januaries that happened recently, I said, you know, me and you know, my husband, fire commander, I said, like, hey, you know, we're going to really buckle down and, you know, I'm going to lose weight and we're going to be healthier. We did that. We made some, you know, we made progress in our diet and things like that. It's still in losing weight. And what I said was, if we don't lose weight in this next year, then by next January, I'm going to attempt weight loss surgery. And I feel like that wasn't, like, I feel like it was like 2 years ago. I'm not quite sure. Anyway, but hey, I'm still attempting it. So that was my decision, that, you know, I told my fertility doctor, I was like, yeah, you know what, I've thought about having weight loss surgery, and if that's what I need, you know, because he really sat me down, and he was explaining, you know, like, they made great strides, and it's really good for patients who do have PCOS, because, you know, there's just so much that's going on with the hormones, and with the insulin resistance, and everything that, you know, just taking, bypassing your intestine and causing that malabsorption for the insulin resistance and whatnot is really helpful for patients with PCOS. And then, of course, just losing the weight in general. is really good. So, I mean, as soon as I left his office, he said he was going to refer me or whatever. I'm not that kind of person. I'm not going to wait around. So I was like, you know, because I had taken the entire day off to meet with my fertility doctor because I didn't know what else procedures he wanted to do. And when I left his office an hour later and we were no closer to doing anything, I was like, well, I'm not going to leave this day wasted. So I contacted the weight center that he referred me to. They have online seminars, so you can do that. So I, in the car, in the parking lot of the fertility doctor's office, I watched the online seminar and then called the patient advocates and everything, and I got the ball rolling, because I can't wait around, you know, I'm not a waiter, you know, I'm like, let's get this done, let's get this accomplished, let's get her done, you know. So So I started that whole process. I got in, and I don't even have my book here to tell you any dates or anything like that. Unfortunately, I do know this was March 4th that this occurred, because we did a video because we were trying to document our fertility process, and so we have previous videos, and so I had a video from the doctor's office where I was just really heartbroken, and did I tell y'all we worked out? And that's why I look like this. Oh, my battery's done. I need to hurry up. Okay, so. So I left the fertility doctor's office and then got started with the weight center. That was March 4th. And then I got in with the surgeon and met with the, what is she called? The patient advocate, maybe? And the nutritionist. I met all three of them on March 23rd. And then started my process with my PCP on the medically monitored dieting jazz on March 31st. And just so you know, my first weight at the weight center on March 23rd was 405 pounds. It was actually technically like 404.7, but what's 0.3 when you weigh fucking 400 pounds? You know, what's 0.3 of a pound? You know, really, what is that? Like, let's see, 4-ish ounces, you know, right? Let's see, 5 would be 8 ounces, and then you got 2 is 25 is like 4, so like 4.5 ounces, whatevs. Anyway, so, math is difficult right now. So what's freaking 4 or 5 ounces when you weigh 400 freaking pounds, you know? So we're going to say 405, okay? Okay, good. So that's fun stuff. I weigh 405 pounds. And I would never tell soul that bullshit. Sorry. I'd never tell soul. Nobody in my... Except for... Now, let me tell you something, because I know I'm going to call him this, and I've been stopping myself. Okay, so Fire Commander, my husband, Ruben, if y'all met him, you know, at WSFA. His nickname is Weird. That's what we call him in our household. So if I slip up and I call him Weird, just so y'all know who I'm talking about, that's him. His nickname is Weird in our house. It's a long story. I'll tell y'all later about that. It's a cute one. So, just get that out of the way so that I can go ahead and say it so that everybody's on the same page, that Weird is Ruben is Fire Commander. Okay, got it. What was I even gonna say? Well, if there'd be crickets, they'd be chirping right now. Fuck, I don't even know what I was going to say. So, now y'all just know I call them Weird. I have no idea what I was going to say. Anyways, I guess I'm going to wrap this up then, because I don't even know what it's gone right now. And since I'm going on like 30 minutes, I hope it lets me upload that, because I don't know how that's going to work. But I appreciate y'all, and I really hope that y'all follow me in this journey and everything, and watch my videos, and keep me accountable, because I need it, and I appreciate you. See you later, dolls.